All right, so let's take a look at the first system here. Okay, let's talk strategy for a minute. When you're picking which variable to solve for, you want to pick the one that's going to be the easiest to solve for. And the easiest ones are the ones that don't have any coefficients. So like you see y here, it's all by itself. That would be a great variable to solve for because all you have to do is add 2x to both sides and voila, you're done. Okay? You could also solve for y here, but then you would need to deal with that negative. Okay, so you would subtract 2x from both sides, but then you'd have to multiply or divide both sides by that negative to get y all by itself. Okay, so I'm going to choose the easiest one. Okay, right here. I'm going to add 2x to both sides so that this cancels out and I have my, my equation in that nice form. Okay, all I did is I moved that 2x over by adding 2x to both sides. Now, I can substitute in to the other equation here. Do not forget to use parentheses when you substitute in. That was a huge hindrance to you guys getting 5 out of 5 last night, is some people forgot that you have to distribute that negative to everything. So when I write this out, it's like that. So I'm going to distribute the negative here and the negative here. And if I had forgotten my parentheses, then I would have left this as -3 and then gotten my answer wrong. So negative times a negative is a positive. Okay, 2x minus 2x is 0. So that's going to completely cancel out. And what I'm left with is 3 is equal to negative 8. Well, this is exactly like it was for solving multi-step equations. If the two things are not equal to each other and all of the variables have canceled out, this is going to be no solution. Okay, so just like when we did multi-step equations. Now let's take a look at a different problem and see what we get. I'm sure you can guess what's going to happen when it's infinitely many solutions, right? You'll get down to two things that equal each other. Then you know it's infinitely many solutions. Because basically you could plug in anything, it's going to work. Now I've purposely picked two equations that are going to be a little tougher to solve for my variable. Or sorry, no, I really didn't. That's on the practice later. Sorry about that. Okay, I got your hopes up. All right, so for this this set of equations, you honestly could solve for any variable and it will work as long as you do all your calculations correctly. But you tend to end up with fractions. And I don't like fractions. If I can avoid them, I will. They're okay, but sometimes they cause a lot of errors. So I'm going to pick this guy right here. This is a super easy variable to solve for because all I'm going to have to do is add 3x to both sides. So when I do that, this cancels out, and then I'll have y is equal to 3x plus 2. Then I can take this whole thing and plug it in here for y. Bless you. So this will be 6x minus 2 times 3x plus 2 is equal to negative 4. And then I just have to simplify and see what I get. I'm going to distribute here. Distribute here. Okay, 6x minus 6x is 0. So I'm left with negative 4 is equal to negative 4. which we all know because we've been there, done that, this is going to be infinite solutions. Right. So I'm just going to have you guys practice this twice since I'm not assigning homework. I want to make sure you're good on this. And then we're going to start that word problem. Needed a lot of whiteout today. Just one of those days. All right, give it a shot. Was they forgot to update the system, so if you weren't a student for last year, it didn't let you vote. So I have a new link. I'll post it up here real quick for you guys. What's that?
I just couldn't see the link.
Oh, you couldn't see the link, so you were here last year?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll give you the link right now, though, so that way you have it. Actually, Ishan and Alan, I'll just email it to you. Yeah.
My first hour teacher just wrote it down on paper.
Okay. I'm going to email it to you anyways. That way your vote, I want to make sure your vote gets counted. Because they'll, Ms. Smith will know. Second problem. to show me that you completely solved to justify your reasoning. I'm going to quickly go over these, and then we're going to move on to that next problem. This first one is set up so nicely for you. You don't have to solve for anything because they are already telling you what y is equal to. So you just have to plug it in below. So I'm going to do that. So this will be 4 times the whole thing, negative 3/4 x plus 2. Is equal to negative 3x minus 4. And then if I distribute here, this will be negative 3x plus 8 is equal to negative 3x minus 4. If I add 3x to both sides, and actually at this point, even before I add 3x to both sides, these are exactly the same, but these are different. So we know these are going to cancel out. And because these are different, there will be no solution. But let's take it this step further here and actually see it. Okay, 2 things that are not equal to each other. So this one will be no solution. Raise your hand if you got that one. Sweet. Okay, next one. Now, like I said, there's no good variable to solve for here. You're gonna end up with a fraction, and that's okay. And I might pick something, I might be picking something different than what you used, but we should still get to that same place. I'm gonna go ahead and solve for the x in the second equation right here. So I'm going to add 15y to both sides. That's going to drive me crazy. Let me just. Okay, and then I'm going to divide both sides by 6. And I'll get x is equal to. And then I'm going to have to simplify the fraction. I can't actually make it into a whole number. So I'm going to do this. And then 15 over 2 here. Now, don't stress about the fraction, because as soon as you plug it into the other equation, it's going to take care of itself. So I'm going to plug it in right here. So this is going to be 5y is equal to 2 times this whole chunk down here, what y is equal to, 5 halves y plus 15 halves, and then minus 15 from up here. Okay, now when I distribute, you're going to see that all my fractions disappear nicely. So 2 times 5 halves, y will just be 5y, and then this will be 15. Okay. Well, 15 minus 15 is just 0. So you have 5y is equal to 5y, and right there, we can already see that it's going to be infinitely many solutions. I could continue on. I could subtract 5y from both sides and get 0 is equal to 0, but we can already see it. So we will say infinite solutions here. Yes.
For now. With drop subtraction, we have to show like all of our work, like distribute to like until we get like equal like infinite solutions, one solution or like.
If you can see it earlier than that, that's fine with me. So you don't have to get, like, I could see.
So on a trimester test, we won't have to show all of our work?
I want you to show, and if when in doubt, show everything. But if you're super sure, like, I could tell right here that there was going to be no solution because those were exactly the same and those were different. I could have stopped there, okay? And you can too. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
All right, awesome. Okay, so if you guys are good on this, any questions for me before we move on? All right, take out a piece of graph paper, please.